Hi, everybody. Sorry, I'm 30 seconds late. Live on Facebook with a cardio, not really, control class, bar leg with dumbbells. Is anybody there? Okay, cool. Had a little technical setup difficulties this morning. I think I got it now. Make sure I didn't cut my head off too bad. Yep, a little bit. I'm trying to get used to my feet and my head. All right, I'm gonna adjust just a little bit. My feet are a little less critical. I am gonna use a light set of dumbbells. So if you have some dumbbells, ones, twos, threes, a soup can, or they can totally be in fit. Whoa! So there's part of my technical difficulties. My iPad popped off of my tripod. Give me 1 second. I think I got it. Oh my God. I started by overflowing my coffee pot this morning because I had it set for full and I had just a cup under there. It's been that morning and it hasn't even been that long yet. Okay. Oh, no, I can't see my feet at all. Oh, it'll work. I'll give you some cues because I'm good at that part. Oh my gosh. Okay, everybody ready? Maybe there's only like two of you on there today and I'm good. May have to not post this one. Okay, it is struggle bus for Kara this morning for no good reason. All right, we'll see if this will work a little better. All right, and you can see my armpit there. Nice. So excited to be here this morning. I am. Oh, you'd think I was up all night. I was not. I was trying to do it outside, but my husband fertilized the grass, and so I wasn't allowed to go in the grass, and so I had to reset really quickly. Anyway, enough about me. Let's get warmed up. So guys, we're gonna start. If you have a chair or a wall, or I have a ladder barrel, we will use it for some stuff later. You can always use something to do for balancing. You can even use a foam roller, okay? If you have any injuries, please modify. If you have foot stuff, knee stuff, hip stuff, modify your range of motion so that it is safe for you in a pain-free range, okay? We're gonna be mostly standing today. You're not gonna be able to see my feet as much as I thought you were going to, so I will make sure and cue what my foot position is when it's critical. All right, so we're gonna start with our feet about hip distance apart in an ever so slight turnout, right? Like our little Pilates stance, not toes pointing to the wall across from you. A little bit of a turnout. Arms up to the side. We're gonna start with just a plie down. So we're just gonna bend hips and knees and then come back up. As you do this, I want you to bring an awareness to your abdominals drawing in, stabilizing your spine, and your knees are tracking over that second or third toe. So when you're down, if you take a moment, look down, you should be able to see your instep. I want to make sure there's weight on your big toe, your pinky toe, your heel bones. So don't roll out on the big toe, just the big toe or just the pinky toe. All right, I want two more just like this. Now, we're gonna plie down, tap your right leg forward. Step back to plie, bring it down. Step, just the right. Down, tap front. Plie, tap. Plie, tap. Plie, tap. Plie, tap. Four more. Three, two, and one. Hold right here. Now lift the leg forward. Lift. We're going to challenge your balance some today. You can bring the arms down if your shoulders prefer that. Four, three, two. Still on this same side, we're going to put it together. Plie, tap, lift, lower. Plie, tap forward, lift, lower. Step out, leg forward, up. Out, tap, lift, lower. So I had technical difficulties to start this morning, but I have a good workout plan for you. That part did go okay. Four more. Now two, to prove I can sometimes count to two. Last one on this side. Bring it back to just the plie. Bring it down and up. Again, watch your range of motion. Make it yours. Down and up. No pain in the hips or knees. Suction cup the arches. Zip up the legs and the abs as you come tall. Four more, just plie. Three, two, one. Now plie, tap front. Step out, leg forward. Step out, leg forward. Down, tap forward. Last one like this. Now hold, lift the leg. Lift, lift, maybe add arms. Lift. So just bring in the heat, warming the body up a little bit. Two, one, ready? Here's our combo move. Down to our plie, tap forward, lift the leg, lower the leg, and step out. Up, forward, lift. Out, down, forward, lift, down, lift, down, forward, lift, lower. Two more, just like that. And bring it in to our parallel position. Okay, we're going to go to a little side lunge. So I'm going to step out with my left leg. So I'm going to step out to a little lunge shape. Okay, as soon as that foot plants, knee, hip, line up, booty goes back. And I'm just going to tap it back. Side lunge, bring it back. So we're going out, bring it back. Out and then down. Don't try to rush this. Step lower. All 10 toes are forward here. Okay, we're going to add a knee lift. So step up, lift the knee. If lifting the knee doesn't work for you, tap the floor right next to your other foot. So we're going down and up. Down, lift the knee. If you need a wall, or a bar, or a chair, go for it. We have two more. Stay here. All right, hold that position. Hold that position. We're gonna go into a curtsy. So we're stepping back to a curtsy. Find the knee. Curtsy, find the knee. Curtsy, find the knee. Back. Three more. And then you guessed it. We're gonna put it together. Okay, so find the knee, pause. Step out to that lateral lunge. Find your knee, curtsy, find your knee, or tap the floor. Lateral lunge, tap, curtsy, tap, or the knee raise. You pick your level. Find the knee, lateral, pause, curtsy, lift, right? So we go forward, side. We're getting a bunch of planes of motion here. We're getting that lateral movement and that rotational movement. One more time. And then take that back leg back for me in that curtsy. Straighten that back leg. I'm going to angle a little more so you can see what I mean there. Abs in. Reach forward. Rise up on your tippy toes. Lower it down. Rise up on your tippy toes. Lower it down. Make sure that calf is nice and lengthened out. Give me two more of those. Just reach and lower. Reach and lower. And stand back up. I'm going to scoot a little bit to the other side of my space. It's the other leg, lateral lunge. So I'm going to step out and then go down. Breathe in. I'm hinging at that hip and then in the knee. My foot plants and then I go down and back. So don't let that knee go forward. Just the lunge. We're going to build it up. Okay, we're going to add a lunge to knee raise. Lunge, lift the knee. Again, remember, you can tap the toe. You don't have to lift it. It's not all the way up to a tabletop. It's just finding the knee or calf. Find your knee. Two more here. Pause. Ready? Curtsy. Find the knee. Curtsy. Find the knee. Abs are in. You got this. You should start feeling your booty, your gluteals, your peaches, the cupcakes. Lots of names for that, hiney. Two more. Okay, pause. Ready? We put it together. Step out, down, find the knee. Curtsy, knee. Lateral, knee. Curtsy, knee. Lateral, knee. Back. Yep. Keep it slow enough that you're in control. It's warming us up. Two more. Last time. Now, take that leg back in that curtsy stand. Reach forward, get that back heel down, and rise up and down a little bit. Rise up and down a little bit. I wanna make sure that calf is ready for our next series. Two, and one. All right, back to a squat. I'm gonna stand sideways just for a postural assignment, and I'm gonna turn forward again. So I'm gonna sit back, hips over, behind the hip, hips behind the heels. The knees stay right in line with the foot, not past the toes, so don't let them go forward. Stick your booty back. And then rise up, okay? So we're gonna go down, down, up, up. Reach and pull. Reach and pull. Sit and stand. Sit and stand. Nice and slow. Four. Sit. Two, one, stand up. Arms overhead like a little ballerina. Articulate up to a calf raise. And calf raise. Four, three, so not to pop up, but to peel up. Last one, heels down. Now we combo that. Squat, rise up on tippy toes. Sit back, rise it up. Don't jump. Big movements, we can get that heart rate up with low impact or no impact up. And you're just lifting to your ability on that calf raise. Lift. Five, you got this. Four, three, two, one. Meet me in the squat. Now left knee raise. Whoop, check your balance. My squat, right knee raise, squat. Knee raise, squat, knee raise. I have a little pattern we'll be doing here as well in a minute. All right, we're gonna end up, after we finish this little squat knee raise, we're gonna stay on one side. So next time, not this one, I want you to pause up. So my right knee is up. If you do left, you're just gonna have to make sure you're always opposite of me. So I don't want your knee way high. I want it like touching the side of your calf. We're gonna rotate that knee out and in. So a little rotation from the hip. If you need to balance it, grab it. Otherwise, I'm challenging it a little bit today. Nothing too crazy. You can always put your foot on the floor. Okay? Now hold it. Okay? Bring your arms out front. Here's a little pattern we're gonna do. As that leg goes away, we're gonna turn the opposite way. Okay, do that two more times after this one. Rotate, just so you know what we're doing. Okay, so now, sit back, squat, right knee raise, leg goes out and in. Okay, start with that, squat, knee raise, rotate, forward, squat, stay with the right leg, the other one to lift. Rotate and back, squat, lift, rotate. Your hip getting warm on the standing leg, should be. Okay, add the twist if you can, it's optional. Twist away, squat, lift, rotate, center, squat, lift, rotate, center, squat, lift, rotate, center, and breathe. Three more. One more. And bring it in. Just squat it down. Rise up to a calf raise. sit and lift. I'm gonna let you recenter your balance for four more. And then we're gonna start with squat, left knee raise. After these last two, no calf raise needed here. Sit back, left knee raise. Squat, left knee raise. Okay? We're gonna hold this one up, stay right here. Now just rotate the leg out and in. Out and in. Trying to stay as tall on that standing leg as you can. Now, hold this next one out. Arms are at chest height. Now rotate away from that knee a little bit and bring it back center. Rotate, center. Okay, are we ready? Let's put it together. Squat, knee raise, rotate and turn, center. Squat, knee, twist, center. Squat, knee, twist, center. We're twisting away from that leg right now. Sit, lift, rotate, center. Squat, knee raise, rotate, center. Squat, knee, twist, center. For four. This is our last one. Squat, knee, twist, center. All right. If you have your mat, you can go to your mat. I didn't grab one out today. We're gonna hinge over, find a little down dog. So find the floor, walk down, feel down, and then walk yourself out to that triangle shake pike down dog. And then I want you to pedal your feet. So your little running or prancing ankles, push the heel down. Keep the spine long and the hips to the sky. Yeah? Okay. We're gonna add on to this. If going to the floor doesn't work for you, you can lean against a chair or the wall and do a standing version. I want you all to meet me in a plank. Find your plank. All right. I don't think you're gonna be able to see all of me, but that's okay. Bring your right leg forward outside of your right hand. So you're in a big lunge, okay? And then we're gonna take that right hand off of the floor and reach to the sky. And then bring it down. Same side, step back to the plank. Right leg forward, bring it way forward, squeeze that left leg long, and then rotate to the sky. And bring it back. Step back to plank. Two more on that right side. Step it forward, reach, bring it down, plank, slow, right leg forward, rotate to the sky, bring it down, meet me in plank. All right, ready? Left leg forward, rotate to the sky, bring the hand down, and the foot comes back. Left leg forward, left hand to the sky, bring it down, again. Forward, rotate, bring it down, back, forward, and rotate, bring it down, and back. Knees down for a moment. You can do this on your forearms if you need to for this next section. We're gonna do a plank with the knee tap to the same side elbow, and then we'll do opposite side, okay? This is our core and upper body warm up here. Find your plank, forearms or wrists. Pull your elbow forward to the right knee. Left elbow to the left knee. Do that again. Right to right. Meet me in plank. Left to left. Right to right. Left to left. Push back into that down dog or rest your knees if you prefer. Now we're gonna go to the opposite elbow. Meet me back in your plank. Okay, you can do this on your knees and forearms and just hold the plank. Bring your right knee to the left elbow. Left to the right. Get a little twist. Bring out that waist. Strong in the shoulders. Hips as low as you can keep them with a straight spine. One more time. Each side. Press back to your down dog. Walk your hands into your feet. Softening your knees when you need to. And then restack. And I am already a dirty mess. That's our warm up. Okay. So you guys grab your little weights, if you're up for it, okay? If the weights get heavy, series. We're going to find a little tree pose or a little passe leg. Don't bring it all the way up to your pubic bone. Just bring it to your knee or your calf, okay? Somewhere in there. Option to put it on the floor. Elbows in and then ever so slightly out. Roll those shoulders back and down. Abs in, spine long. Find where you're going to hold your foot. Know the floor's right there, right? Okay. Serve your bladder in and out. Just holding it there. And that knee's just ever so slightly out. Arms and legs are both on a little bit of like 30, 45 degree angle. Reach it slow for two. Now, as you reach it out, extend the right knee. Bring it back in. So you're just, the thigh's not going anywhere. Just the left foot kicks out. As the arms go out, the leg goes out. Can you do two more? You can. All right. Now, take it out there, hold it. Now lower the foot towards the floor and the hands towards the floor. Lift them both back up. So now we're just doing a little present. Lift and lower. Make sure that standing leg's not hyperextending on me. 30, 2, 1. All right, bring it back to that fine mini tree. Elbows in. We're gonna put that together. So we're gonna extend elbow and knee. Tap the floor, lift, bend elbow and knee. Reach, lower, lift, bend. Reach, lower, lift, bend. Reach, lower, lift, bend. Two more. Woo, we got this, right? And bring it in and down. All right, so same leg. I'm gonna turn a little on an angle so you can see this one. I'm gonna find that little tree pose again. I'm gonna flip my palms down. And I'm gonna reach to the ground in our little deadlift-like move or a little arabesque. And I'm gonna bring it right back up to the start, okay? So those elbows are in, knees and foot are together. Take your palms to the floor and tip it over. And then bring it back up. You can always have that other foot just sliding on the floor instead of going up if you need to, okay? We're gonna pull this one over, hold it over. Ready? Pull the hands back to the hips. You can put that foot on the floor if you need to, or keep it lifted. If you have it lifted or lowered, squeeze your tush quite as tight. And we're doing that little kind of chest expansion and a little hinge forward. That left leg should be pretty on fire. 4, 3, 2, 1, and bring it in. Give it a little shake, shake. All right, I need a quick, super quick set. We're gonna repeat all that on the other leg. Yeah, same thing. So that gave your shoulders and upper arm a little break. Okay, so find your little tree, find the knee, elbows in. I really want you to squeeze those shoulder blades down. You should feel this back body activate right here, okay? Just the arms, reach them out, squeeze them back in. Reach them out, squeeze them in. Reach them out. Pull them in. Don't just fling those weights or arms if you have invisible weights. Always okay to have invisible weights. You could also, technically, I didn't say earlier, you can do this movement with the flex band around your back, right? Or in a door anchor at the wall. Ready? Add the leg extension. Arms go out, knee straightens, knee bends. Reach. Don't go too wide to the side. It's just a little angle. Fairly wider than shoulder width. Oh, standing leg firing up. Losing my balance. 3, 2, 1. Bring it in. Okay, now we have this straight arm and leg. So take it out, tap the floor, lift, tap. Just this move, just the present and flexion of that front leg. Find the abs so it's not all hip flexor taking over. Really feel that standing leg. Last two like this. And then it gets a timeout because we're gonna take it to the combo. Knee, elbows in. Ready? Reach, lower, lift, bend. Reach, lower, lift, bend. Reach, lower. You got it. Or at least I'm guessing you do. Maybe you're just watching me. Just two more. Feel those shoulders get a break in just a second. Ooh, and I messed up that last one. It's okay. All right, same side. We're gonna go into that deadlift. So just bring your knee up, elbows in to start. I tried to go back to the first leg. Take that left leg out, tip over into your deadlift leg position, and then bring elbows and knee in, okay? So it's really just layering onto what we just did. And we come, make sure that standing leg is not hyperextended as you hinge. And bring it up. Hinge. Oh, we got some leg and hip work happening here. We got two more. Last full range like that. You can also have that foot on the floor right now. Hold it over. Hold it over for me. Ready? Pull those hands back. The foot can go on the floor if you start to lose your balance, or if you just prefer that. Or find your little arabesque. Push back. Push back. Four, three, two, and one. And bring it up. All right. Find your Pilates stance, first position. So my heels are kissing and my toes are just a little bit apart. Okay? So we're going to start. Just weights can just go on your hip for now. And I just want you to find your full range, little plie. And up, and plie, and up. All right, you can dish the weights at any time. If you need the bar, or chair, or wall for balance, go there, okay? So, finding that range, heels are still down. We're gonna go up in a minute, or an option to go up. All right leg only, plie, passe, plie, passe. Hands to the floor. Hands to the hips, if you're joining in with weights. You got that. Three, two, one, hold there. Okay, the weights are gonna be a counterbalance. We're gonna keep that knee bent, turned out. Pinky toe leads the way. Tip over, bring it up, kind of like what we just did, right? Do that again. I'm gonna turn sideways for that angle again. So I started in my little passe. And I'm just going to keep the knee bent, tip forward. Feel free to use a bar or a chair and skip the weights of this. Totally okay. Ready? Combo move. Here we go. Plie, passe twice. Plie, passe, arabesque. Okay, there's our pattern. Plie, passe. Plie, passe. And tip it over. Let the weights be a little counterbalance. Okay, again, plie, passe, still on just the right leg lifting. Two plies, and then one arabesque. Plie, passe. Arabesque. Slow, down and up, down and up, and then tip it over. We got one more. Down and up, down and up. And tip it over and bring it in. Elbows by your side, find your first position. Just give me a little rotation, that little open and close, scapular squeeze. Your hands are kind of making a little W shape. Four, three, two, one. Right here, we're gonna do a little hug the moon as you do a releve before we go to the other side. So lift, lower. Lift. If overhead doesn't work for you, keep it low. You got a droopy moon. Up. Four. Three. Shoulders are down, connected on your back. Last one. Bring it down. Okay. Other leg, plie to passe. So we find your little Pilates stance. This time we're gonna try to bring the arms up and down this way. If that doesn't work for you, go back here, okay? So elbows are soft. We're going to plie, down, hands come up, okay? Add the knee raise. So sit back, pull the right knee up. If it works better for you to opposite, I'm gonna opposite so don't kick my knee. Hands forward as my knee comes up. Sit down, knee up. Just the plie passe. If you need to do something different with your arms, remember it's always okay. It's almost like we're coming up and down out of an open hug position. Two more like this. Ready? Just tip forward. Find your arabesque. Do a couple more of those just to get the pattern. Hands are reaching to the floor as that leg goes out. Again, you could go to a chair. Just that arabesque move. Okay, here we go. Two of our plies. So hands are out. We're gonna go down and lift the left knee. Down and lift the left knee. And then tip over to your arabesque. Bring it up. Plie, knee raise. Plie, passe. Tip it over. Oh, that right hand's on fire. Bring it back up. And then plie, passe. Plie, passe. And that deadlift arabesque out of two shape. Bring it up. And down. And up. Down. This is not my smart side today. Tip it over. It's wibbly wobbly. Remember that foot could be on the floor. Be a tap instead of a full knee up. Tip it over. This is the last one. Down and up with that knee. Down and up with that knee. Tip it over. Whoa. Tip it over. Hold it over. Hold it over. And bring it up. Okay. I want you to set your weights down for me, which gives me a good sip opportunity. I am going to use the bar for balance aid. You can use a wall, a chair, or nothing at all. So I'm going to take that right leg back. This is technically fourth position, but if you were in your Pilates stance, I know you can't see my feet, that's what, I want you to step back so that mini ball would fit between your heel and your arch of the right back leg is lined up with the heel. So slight turn out, technically fourth position, and your feet are wide enough that that ball fits, okay? So, we're gonna do some, basically a stagger squat or a fourth position. We're gonna plie down, your full range, or sorry, halfway down. All the way up, halfway down, all the way up, halfway down, all the way up. I'm gonna rise up onto the balls of my feet. You don't need to go high, but on the balls of the feet can be a little nicer on your knee joint. At least the back leg has to. You can keep the front foot down, but try to keep that back leg hovering the heel. Your knee will line up a little better. If your knee doesn't like this, change your angle of your turnout. Four, three, feel the zipping up, two, and one, hold it up. Here's why I have my chair or bar. I have a lot of barrel. We're gonna tip it over. And back up. Tip it over again. We're working those hips a lot today, right? Tip it over. I'm about a straight arm distance away. And you can have that front heel down or up. And my hip is a little turned out. All right, ready? Put it together. Plie, up, tip. So halfway down, zip it up, lift it over. Down. Up, attitude it. Down, up, and a little open of that pelvis, right? We don't really change anything, we just hinge it over. But both hips are a little more turned out than they were on that last set. All right, last two. Down and up and tip. Now, from here, I want that heel of that upright leg to squeeze from the glute, slow, press across your body like you're wrapping that thigh. I put my standing leg heel down, it's a little nicer. Four, three, two, and one. Bring it in, we got another side and we'll stretch it out. Okay, left leg back, right leg forward. Again, the ball would fit between your heels, that's the distance, okay? A little bit of a turnout, neutral spine. About an arm width away from the bar, chair, wall, or nothing at all, because you got great balance. And then we go down and up. Lift up on your balls of your feet. Big toe, little toe in contact, if that releve works for you. No hyperextending the ankles. Just that smallish range. Halfway, up, a little bit down. All the way tall. tapping that thigh. You're squeezing that left top leg buttock to pull it across. Four, three, two, and one. All right, so our next move, I'm gonna go to this side. Second position to a sweep the leg to a forward bent knee little attitude. So it would be like that little turnout, right? So we start second position plie, sweep the leg forward. Step and sweep. You could hold on to a bar or chair the whole time, or you could leave it as you go out. Find as you come up if you need to. Okay, we're gonna add on a little sweep of the leg. From here, hold. Now the leg goes back. It goes forward and then out. Forward, back, forward, out. Forward, back, forward, out. Forward, back, forward, out. Pause right here. Up and down, full range. Bars are if you need it, right? Okay. We are going to take that same right leg back instead of forward. Back. Extra little booty squeeze. Back. 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 Ready? Back. Forward. Back. Out. Back. Lift. So squeeze it back. Pull it up. Step it out. Same thing we just did, just the opposite leg pattern. Back, forward, down, squeeze. Last time, back, forward, knee in your plie. All right, if you need to turn around, if you need to find a different wall or your chair, we're going to the other side. I set myself up in camera view that I could do both. All right, so just lift forward, plie, lift forward, plie, lift. Second to that little attitude forward. Three. Now we're gonna add this swing right here. Stay up. Sweep it back. Forward. Down. So as you come up, knee comes forward. Sweep. And down. Up. Back. And this could be a tap. I know I didn't say that earlier, but it could. Forward, sweep, forward, hold it. Plie, up and down. Squeeze, can you do this on your toes? Yeah, four, three, two. Now we're gonna lift that leg to the attitude back. So plie, leg comes back, forward, out, right into the combo. Back, forward, out, back. Forward, out, squeeze. Don't just sling it, lift it, squeeze. Squeeze, last two, back, forward, out, back, forward, out, meeting the out. Find your plie, about halfway down, put your hands behind your head. Okay, we need some standing up. Take your right hand, you're gonna reach it towards your right knee and side bend. Come up tall. Legs are static, opposite side. Reach right and up, left and up, right, up, left, up. Four, three, two, and one. Now, a little switch it up. We're gonna take left hand, reach down to the right knee, stand up tall. So now we're going in front and cross. Almost like a little plie saw. Okay, alternating sides. Reach, tall. Reach, tall. Plie if you can. As you reach to the front of the knee, a little cross reach. Meet me in plie, hands behind your head. Okay, right side, reach behind. And up, right hand reaches across, and up, left hand reaches down, and up, left hand reaches across, and up, right, down, up, right, cross, up, left, down, up, right side bend, right cross to stand. Ready? Down. Left side bend, left cross to stand. Walk your feet in. All right, we doing good? Uh-huh. Okay. One more series. We're gonna curtsy, curtsy to second. So you can hold on to a bar if you need to, a wall or door if you need to. I'm gonna start with the right leg, so I'm gonna do that again. Right foot is just gonna step back. There's space between those. Both legs slightly turned out. Curtsy in place. Go down and up, right? So we go down and up. This is our last series, I think, probably. 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, hold your curtsy for a second. So we're gonna curtsy, step out to second, right back, curtsy to second. You have a wall to find if you need it, right? So curtsy, second. Getting a little bit more of that rotation of the hips again, back to second. Curtsy, second. Curtsy, second. 4, 3, 2, 1. Meet me in curtsy. Okay, here's where a door or wall help. Bring your outside, so I got right leg back, right hand up. And I'm gonna lift knee to elbow. Curtsy, lift knee to elbow. Curtsy, knee to elbow. Curtsy, knee to elbow. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, same thing, other leg. Take the left leg back. Slight turn out, separated feet, curtsy in place. Down and up, down and up. Whew, are you guys drippy like me? I hope it's not just me. 4 more curtsies in place. 3, 2, and 1. Okay, so we're gonna add the curtsy to second. So out, curtsy, out. Add some nice arms if you want. Plie second, curtsy. Plie second, or you can just have a tap out. Curtsy, down, curtsy, down. 4 more. 3. Curtsy out. Last curtsy out. Meet me in curtsy. Hand comes up either overhead or to your hand. Okay? Lift knee to elbow. Curtsy, knee to elbow. Or just knee to elbow, right? Curtsy, knee to elbow. Getting some lateral flexion like a curtsy mermaid. That would be weird. They don't have legs. 4. 3, 2, and 1. And bring it in. All right, you guys. So from here, hold on to something. Cross your ankle. Give yourself a figure four stretch. We're bringing this back down. And bring it up. Other leg. Something to balance, or you could sit down on the ground and do this figure four. Unlock that hip. All right, now, take your left leg behind your right and the left hand up. And then I want you to stick that hip up. If you got something to hold on to, great. If you don't, it's okay, just reach across so you counterbalance. I want you to stretch the hip on that left outside and bring it up. Take the right leg behind that. Right leg is straight and long and a little bit behind you. Right hand up. Reach over, hold on to something if you need to, or just reach across, almost like you're pulling on your hip bone to counterbalance and hold. Big stretch to the obliques and those lateral hips, because we worked them a lot. And then I'm gonna stretch out your quad. So if you can grab your foot, pull your pelvis forward, and give yourself a little stretch there. If you need to do it more in the little lunge stretch, you can pull pelvis forward and lower down until you feel that thigh stretch. So whichever one works for you. I don't want to make your knee mad doing this. or put that foot on the floor, or do the combo like I did. Then you get a little more quad, a little more hip flexor. And lower down, pulling that pelvis forward, breathing a lot. And then bring it in. All right, you guys, give me a big inhale up to the sky. Exhale it down. We're gonna roll it down. Reach up to the sky, nod your chin, reach arms forward, be that waterfall cascading off of the mountain. Or as I really like to say, you're leaning over a barbed wire fence to pick the neighbor's tomatoes. And you don't want to get poked in the belly. And reach back all the way up. Reaching up. I didn't want to change myself at least once. Reach up on your tippy toes. Reach, reach, reach. Lower your heels. Reach to the sky. And then round forward, dive forward. Or if you need to hinge forward, hinge forward. See if you can find the floor. Soften your knees if you need to find the floor. Walk your hands over to one side and get a little stretch in the hip. Don't let the hips turn, just the shoulders. Walk it back to center and into the other side. Kind of pull on that floor. Hands back out. Widen your stance. I walked my feet out to that second plie. Drop the hips down towards the ground as far as your hips and knees will let you. You know, like a wide toddler squat, right? How they sit down like this. And then maybe you reach up and stand up, or you roll yourself back. All right, you guys. Thanks for holding tight with me and my little quick technical difficulties at the beginning where I accidentally threw my iPad to the floor. Thanks so much for joining me. I don't usually do this, but just to prove it, you can see all the wrinkles, and you can see the sweat running down my nose and the smearing mascara. That's my day today. Happy Friday, you guys. Tomorrow I am on the regular page doing Saturday morning, a restore class. And then anybody that has a TRX at home, if you want to join me, I am going to do a Zoom TRX class. I had 6 hours of Pilates on the TRX workshops earlier this week. And starting at 10, you know, in like 8 minutes, I am doing a 6-hour workshop on the TRX. So I have 6 more hours of exercise starting now. So restore is going to be needed in the morning. Have a great day, you guys. Thank you so much. Not posting that one to YouTube.